Welcome back to Totally Accurate Battle Simulator. My name is Crow, and today we have an amazing mod brought to you by the YouTuber Tar Yosh. If you don't know who that is, he makes Taps content. Go and check him out. I have a link in the description down below, as well as in the comment section to his YouTube channel. Go and give him a sub. Tell him on his most recent video Crow sent you, and give him a big thank you for this amazing mod. Guys, it's Larry, and Larry is a skeleton. Look at his arms. Look at his torso. Everything about him is a skeleton, except for his face. I think they wanted to preserve the Larry face. That is phenomenal. There are 6 units in total in this skeleton mod by Tar Yosh. Now, what I want to see is what happens to Larry when he dies. Does he break apart like a proper skeleton? So what we'll do is we'll summon a whole bunch of these guys to make sure that Larry breaks apart. This is really all I want to see. So Larry still does throw the potions. They still do their job, but does Larry break apart? Sorry, Larry. This is for science. He's frozen. There it is. And it seems like he is. Hold on a second. We need more proof. What's a great way to find out if Larry breaks apart? Shoot him with some cannons. Here we go. Oh, Larry does break apart. And his head floats in the sky. Oh, I'm so sorry, buddy. It was for science. I had to do it. I had to know. And ironically, each of these pieces have collision detection. Interesting. So that was the skeleton Larry. Next, we have the skeleton Taekwondo. That's so cool. How did he figure out how to remove the normal body and put in a skeleton? How about skeleton Taekwondos versus normal Taekwondos in 3, 2, 1, go. Just like that, they dive in. They did a cool barrel roll, but some of them broke apart immediately. And in fact, they have way less HP than the regular Taekwondo units. You can see their body parts flying through the sky. Oh, it's so cool. What do we have here? Skeleton vampires. Why not just take 2 fantasy units and slap them into one? Skeleton vampires who are turning into bats? Is that what's up with the wings going on? Check out their faces. That's so cool. You can actually still even have the hair of the vampire there. Here they go. They don't turn into bats, but they do leap like crazy. Oh, and they have a fear effect. Check that out. You can see the skulls on these guys, and they're still being bit. The vampires are still sucking the life out of these poor... That doesn't look appropriate. That looks very inappropriate. Okay, these skeleton vampires are very cool, very powerful, and very cool. The fear effect, I mean, what a great combination, forcing them to run away while you suck the life out of them. And I also love the sound effect, it's fantastic. Oh, there are some dead vampire bones strewn about, as well as vampire wings. No, it seems like the vampires are absolutely overpowering these poor hobbits. It's like 3-on-1. Up next, we have skeleton harpooners. So we're going to do our usual test. We'll do the ice giant test to see if they're just as effective. But you can see, again, they have the beard of the harpooner, the hat and the outfit, but you can see all the skeleton bones popping out. Will their harpoons have a fear effect? It's a great question. Let's find out in 3, 2, 1, go. We shoot the harpoons. He's stuck, and there is no fear effect. So the harpooners, the skeleton harpooners, are just as effective as a normal harpooner for trapping the ice giant. So if we remove the ice giant, have a regular unit, maybe the melee kick has a fear effect. That move they do. Let's find out. Okay, here we go. We have harpooners on one side and then regular pirates on the other. I want to see if the harpooners also have a built-in fear mechanism for being a skeleton. Here we go. They shoot out the harpoons. They bring them in and... Oh, I heard... What the... How did he get feared? What scared you? What caused the fear? There was no harpoon in you. Look, over there, again, another fear. So the fear does happen, but it doesn't seem to be a melee trigger. I wonder what's triggering it. This is very cool and terrifying. Skeleton Valkyries, check that out. Not nearly as attractive and cool looking as the regular Valkyries, but they're skeletons, and I'm hoping they have some cool powers when they dive in on the Viking ranks in 3, 2, 1, go. Here they go. They dive in, a lot of speed. And yes, the units are being feared. The sheer terror of the skeleton units are causing the units to flee. The Vikings are terrified of the Valkyries, who are picking up and throwing around the enemy units. These are very cool. A little crowd control. Take the damage of a Valkyrie, add the crowd control of the skeleton, and it's a very powerful combo. So you go 3-on-1 on this poor guy over here. However, while they do have the crowd control effect, the skeleton versions have a lot less HP, they're just more fragile, so it's a bit of a balancing there. Very cool. And now for our mega unit, each faction needs the big unit, the skeleton wheel. You have a skeleton warrior pushing a wagon filled with a skeleton archer and a reaper, because, you know, you don't even need the skeleton archer, you just have the reaper. You have the skeleton wheels in 3, 2, 1, go! In they go. Some of the skeleton wheels broke apart. Some of them aren't even moving. And some of them did move in, and they broke the ranks of the knights. That was disgusting. Let's watch this again in slow motion. So what happens is these skeleton units, the wagons get close. The reapers realize, hey, I can slice stuff. And as soon as they get close, the slicing size come out and they just send everything flying. And then the tentacles, they pick up a whole bunch of squires and off to the races go the wagons. I mean, sure, the Reaper's a very powerful, very terrifying unit, but you give him a car, you give him a ride, and you escort him into battle, that's just a lethal combination. Here we go, an equal fight. The new skeleton faction, Tar Yash's skeleton faction, versus the spooky faction. In the front, you've got your skeleton Taekwondos, your skeleton vampires, your skeleton Larrys, who are my boys, the Reapers on wagons, the Reapers on wheels, and then the Valkyries in the sky and the Harpooners around the outside versus skeleton warriors, skeleton archers, the crazy candlehead people, vampires, swordcasters, pumpkin catapults, and Reapers in the rear. This is an equal point fight in 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, the vampires leaped in, the catapults are launching, the Valkyries are in, the candles are shooting, here come the Reapers on wagons. There's a lot going on in the middle here. The Reapers are doing serious damage to the front line of the faction, of the spooky faction. Now we've got some Reaper on Reaper action. Oh! Can anyone get to the catapults in the back? That's a big question that I have. We do have our lovely boy, Larry. All of our Larrys and our Harpooners are back here still doing work, still causing some backup support, but the Swordcasters are just ruining things. All of the Blue Reapers are alive. All three Blue Reapers are still alive. They're moving in on the Harpooners. Guys, Tar Yash's faction is very cool, but not nearly as strong as the official spooky faction. I don't even know who's left alive. Hold on. Where are they going? Oh, there's a Taekwondo unit. There was a single Taekwondo unit way out here. I don't know how he survived. But the Taekwondo is going to go and challenge three Reapers at once with an obvious result. The blue team wins. Spooky faction is more powerful.